New Mutants is out in theaters now, finally, after 3 years. I never thought that I would ever say I would ever see this movie, after how many delays it has had. New Mutants is about a group of mutants that are trying to discover their powers and trying to escape from this facility as they are being experimented on. Now, like I said, New Mutants I never thought was going to see the light of day. The fact that I actually saw this in a movie theater in 2020 is just astounding. New Mutants is really the conclusion or the final movie in Fox's X-Men series before it goes into the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Dark Phoenix was the last mainline X-Men film. This is really the final Fox film, and it's fine. I don't think this is anything special. I also don't think it's as bad as critics are saying it is. It's just so-so. It's okay. What I did like about this movie is all five of these actors have great chemistry together. They form this group, they have this camaraderie, they have a sense of friendship, at least, maybe not at first, but as the movie goes along, you can get a better understanding as to where they're coming from as characters. I think that their characters are okay, they're adequate, they're not developed to their fullest, but there's enough there for you to latch onto, and all the actors just seem like they would just be friends in real life. I really know that that Comic-Con at home, I think it was Comic-Con at home, where they were actually discussing the movie at when Comic-Con at home was happening. They all seemed like they were a lot of fun on set and seemed like that they all got along together. The acting, though, by most of them, there were instances where some of the accents threw me off, mostly Charlie Heaton's accent. At times, Maisie Williams' accent threw me off. So that was a bit of getting used to. But after I got used to that, it was fine. It was just some of the line delivery, especially from the main girl, I thought was just kind of poor. Maybe that's a testament to her ability as an actress. I don't really want to say whether or not she is a bad actress or anything like that. I got to see her in more things first before I come to that conclusion. But I didn't think that she was that great in this movie. Our lead actress was just delivering lines almost like she was a bit of a robot, saying things in over-exaggerated tones, as did most of the other actors in this movie. Just chemistry amongst them was great. It's just their acting just, it didn't seem like they cared all that much. They just knew that this was a throwaway X-Men movie. The humor also fell a bit flat for me. There's one character in here, it's the other guy in the group, who is not Charlie Heaton, and he's just throwing jokes out left and right, and none of them were landing for me. Maybe one got like a hearty chuckle, but the others, I was just like, no, don't say that. That's just creepy. It's all this momentary passing humor that just didn't really work for me. And there's expository dialogue in this movie that explains the backgrounds of the characters, but it doesn't show the backgrounds of the characters. The one important aspect of storytelling is to show, not tell. I feel like the characters would have had more of an impact on me, and I would have actually cared about them more if I had seen what they had been through rather than hearing about what they had been through. I'm just more of a visual, hands-on type of person. That's why I really need to see that as a visual type of thing. This movie's also not as much of a horror movie as it's been promised that it would be. I wasn't scared all that much. I didn't think that there was a lot of horror elements to this movie. There's some horror imagery in there, but it wasn't scary. It didn't make me jump or anything, like leap out of my seat. And some of the creature designs were just a bit bland, but nevertheless, you can have a bit of fun with this movie, especially in the second half of the movie, because it significantly picks up in the second half. And while the third act of the movie is a bit CGI heavy, that was when I was having the most fun. That's when I was entertained. Sometimes you just need that big CGI finale to really satisfy your brain and try and get some of your mental capacity back, because there were the first half of this movie I was feeling a bit exhausted. The second half picked up, and when it seemed like there was a mystery, that's when I actually became invested in the movie. New Mutants, it's fine. It's honestly nothing to write home about. Would I see it again? I mean, maybe. I'll probably buy the Blu-ray just because I have all the other X-Men movies on Blu-ray, but it's not special. It's just there. It exists, and it was finally released, and all the actors are like 3 years older now, so I'll say you'll enjoy the New Mutants with at least 3/4 worth of a bucket of popcorn. So guys, what did you think of the New Mutants? Drop me some feedback in the comments section below. I will leave my link to my website in the description below as well. You guys are the best. Thank you for watching. My name is Alex Madden, and I'll see you at the movies somewhere.